Hey guys, in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to replace the headlights on a first generation Acura TSX. And because this is a do-it-yourself video, I wanna keep it as short as possible. So let's get right to the material. Okay, the very first thing we need to do is remove this trim piece right here. And then we need to remove the grill. And then there's two screws. That one is just a Phillips screw. Notice how these headlights are a little bit faded. They're not that bad, but you're gonna see the upgrade once we switch them to the new ones. We need to remove this piece to access that screw right there. And that's a 10 millimeter, by the way. 10 millimeter here and here. Now that we turn the steering wheel to the right, we need to make our way to that screw that holds the bumper. What we're trying to do is just loosen the bumper, and that's a 10 millimeter screw. And there's one more screw that is holding a little bracket that we're trying to get to. It's right there. I'm gonna focus it that well. And as I said earlier, we're trying to avoid removing the bumper because the bumper has been removed a few times, so I just don't wanna break more clips. So we're gonna remove the horn just because it's in the way. I haven't seen another video that does that, but we're gonna do it. Trying to get to the main bracket. Did I say we're removing it? No, my friends were removing it. I don't wanna take credit. It's about punching the mouth. Now learning from what we did on this side, we're just gonna remove whatever's in the way just to get to the bracket a little bit easier. I think we found another screw to remove underneath that bracket. So we got a little bit ahead and we disconnected three plugs. This is the one for the high beam, and then the one for the main HID, and then the one for the side marker. And once we remove the other ones, I'm gonna show you how he did it so that you can see that it's very easy to do. There's another 10 millimeter screw at the very bottom of the bumper that we didn't wanna remove, but we're just gonna remove it to make sure that we're not putting too much stress on the little tab. And it's a 10 millimeter as well. It seems like that gave us enough wiggle room. And we're gonna be able to take it out without having to remove any more screws. There's a fourth connector, and that's for the ballast for the HIDs that we forgot to remove, and we're about to do that right now. So there's four, one for the high beam, one for the HID, one for the ballast, and one for the turn signal, and the assembly is off. We're gonna remove the ballast on the original headlight. And it's just three Phillips screws. It's pretty easy. And there's another wiring harness that we have to remove in here. Okay, so there's two tabs.
This one and then that one on the bottom.
One on the other side.
You just gotta press them.
Just press them. They come out. And you gotta be really careful because these are old parts. And I wonder how toast that plastic is. So the valve is off. And now we're gonna put it onto the new one. You're gonna have to transplant the ballast as well as this housing right here. And this one is the one that holds the harness to the actual headlight. So just remember that everything that we do on the driver's side, we're gonna have to do it on the passenger as well. So right now we need to get to the HID, and this is the cover for the HID. And this is kind of like a twist, so just twist it to the left and it's gonna come off. So after removing the cover, we made our way to the HID. So there's one harness that you have to remove, that green tab right there. You remove it. And there's gonna be two clips that you're gonna push down into the side. And then you pull back and you're gonna see the actual bulb. And it's out. So now we're gonna put it on the new headlight. Remember, there's four main lights in this headlight. One is gonna be the side turn signal. The other one is gonna be the HID. Then you're gonna have your amber light and your high beam. So we're gonna have to remove one by one and transfer them to the new headlight assembly. So the first one to do is the main HID, and that's what we're doing right now.
So this one, clip.
Press down those clips to hold the HID in place so that when you're driving, it doesn't shake. Now we're gonna have to do the side marker right here. We're gonna transfer this to this.
You twist to the left, and you pull up.
Now we're gonna do the amber. It's on. And now the high beam. Looks just like a rubber cover that just snaps out. And now we made our way to the actual clips to remove the high beam. And it comes right off. And we're gonna transplant it to the new assembly. Here. Now we're ready to put the covers. So we're gonna start with the rubber cover for the high beam. Snaps right in. And then we do the cover for the HID. And then we're gonna attach the ballast to this one. Align it correctly so you don't bend any of the teeth. Three screws. And we're done with the assembly. So now we're gonna put it in the car. And we're gonna do one at a time. So we're first gonna install the driver's side that we just changed all the bolts on. And it's just a mirror image of what we did to disassemble it. So you're gonna put in the side marker first. So we made it with the ballast, it's plugged, then the high beam, right here. And then that's it. We're gonna align it first. Okay, so it seems like the headlight, and something I forgot to mention when we moved it, is the headlight is held by three main screws. One at the top and two at the bottom. Make sure that when you put this tab right here, it's on top of the fender. Otherwise, it's not gonna align on the side. And once you have it like this, you can move on and tighten the first top screw. So make sure you don't tighten this all the way so that you can have a little wiggle room to align this perfectly so that you can have the plate you need to make it sit flush on the fender.
And doesn't need to be really tight because you don't want to break this bracket on the plastic bracket on the bottom.
A good idea is not to remove both of the headlights at the same time. So anytime you need to come and reference the other one, that's what we're doing. So I feel lucky that we didn't remove the other one and we wouldn't have anything to go by. Okay, so now we can snap this trim back. So it's good to go. Now we need to get to the two bottom screws. So most of these screws are Phillips and 10 millimeters, and there's a couple of 12 millimeters bolts as well. And then we can come back and tighten up the top one. We just put the horn back, and we're not gonna put the bottom screw that I thought held the headlight, but it doesn't. It just only holds the bumper, but we're gonna have the bumper loose for now because we want to remove this headlight and we want to have full access to this as well. We're going to do exactly the same thing. All the screws are off, and now what we're going to do is just remove all the plugs. And it's off. Okay, so we're gonna do the same thing. I don't think we need to cover that. We did something different on the driver's side because we removed the whole bracket here. So we need to remove this bracket and attach it to the new headlight assembly. I don't know how it happened because my buddy was working on one side and I was working on the other. And I guess we removed different screws and it came out like this. And because we're playing around with the bumper, it may scratch the light that is already on. So we put this rag to prevent it from getting scratched. On the driver's side, we took off the bumper with this bracket. What we should have done is there's a screw right here that if we would have taken it off, this bracket would have stuck to the light. And that would have been a better idea. And that's what we did with the passenger side. So that's gonna be an easier setup. The only challenge with this is that we would have gotten to that screw that is at the very back.
Right there.
But that, right here. Mm-hmm. But that would have been a better idea than the one we did on the driver's side. But live and learn. We'll know for the next time.
Yeah, and you can get through it with an extension, like you said.
Yeah.
You can see it from there. With a longer extension, you can get that 10 millimeter screw out.
Okay, so that would save you maybe like 10, 20 minutes at least. Live and learn. We have to remove this bracket because, as I told you, we shouldn't have taken it off from the assembly. And that's the best way to be able to line up the screw right there. And now it's just gonna snap right back in to the bumper once we're done with this side. So now notice how everything is lined up, the bracket, the tab, and the screw. It's gonna come right on. And because we're gonna do the same to the other side, the bumper should just slide right in. And now we're gonna attach the bracket. Notice how we have a long extension to be able to clear the light assembly. And that's the main screw that holds the bracket. So now we're gonna have to slide the bumper into these tabs right here, being really careful not to scratch the lights. Notice how there's a little nipple that holds the bumper here. And now we did the same to the other side. And now it's just a matter of tightening every single screw and retainer and clip that this bumper has. Now we already put the bumper. We're gonna put the two horns that were in the way. And it's fully installed.
They're on. Yep.
And here they are, brand new headlights. Tell me what you guys think. I do think that there's nothing that ages cars more than faded headlights, because in the case of this car being silver, he hides imperfections really well. If you saw my introductory video, I show you where the car was keyed, and then the clear coat starting to fade in some areas like here. So I am contemplating painting this car, but for now, I think replacing the headlights makes the car look really good. I also got the fog lights because this one's broken and both of them are faded. So I'm gonna replace both of them with aftermarket ones. I wasn't too happy about getting aftermarket fog lights, but the problem is that they're no longer available. I couldn't source them through Acura. So I bought some aftermarket ones. So probably by the next video, you're gonna see brand new fog lights as well. Thank you for making it this far. I usually upload videos regarding my ownership experience in the different cars that I've owned throughout the years, like a 2018 Lexus RX 350, then I moved on to a 2021 Tesla Model Y Performance. Then I also own another car that is a 325i, a BMW 325i from 1989, and then this 2007 Acura TSX. Occasionally, I also upload videos of vehicles that viewers allow me to test drive on my channel. I'll see you next time.